I really like this lab. It's about counting, well, counting in loops. But the reason I think it's interesting is we're trying to kind of come up with a connection between the idea of that programming stuff takes time, not obviously just time to write it, but also time to run it. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to come here and I'm going to put together a summation of integers just to kind of warm up, and then a factorial. So we've done factorials in the past as recursive. Now we're going to do factorials as a for loop again. And then we're going to adjust it by actually creating this as an operation count. So we're going to count how many steps it actually takes us to do the factorial. Okay, and the reason that we care is that there's this NChooseK function that, you'll have heard of, like if I've got five people, how many ways can I arrange them into groups of three? And there's like all these different ways to come up with an n choose k. So we want to do this with an operation count. So basically, I need to create the operation count on the factorial so that I can use it for this one. And so there's this way to do n choose k, there's this way to do n choose k, and there's this way to do n choose k. And so by doing this three different ways, it's really interesting because some of them work well on some numbers and some of them work well on other numbers, and that's kind of what I want to show in putting this together. All right, so again, this is kind of a warm-up, I guess. So I'm going to come in here into MATLAB because it's funner, and I'm going to create a function, and it's a new function. We always start the word function when we make a function in MATLAB. And the output is y, the function name is some integers, and then n. So the n is going to be the input. So basically, we just want to sum the numbers 1 through n. So looking at a summation, the first thing in your brain should be like, ah, for loops. So I'm literally just going to like taking dictation, reading from this right here. So I'm going to have for k going from 1 to n, and I want to add k to my summation. So every time I go through the loop, I want to add k to the new summation. So my output is going to be y, so I want to keep adding k to the previous value of y. And then we want to think about, well, how do we want to start y if we're doing this as a for loop? And you think about, okay, so if I'm going to be adding stuff, what's kind of like neutral in addition? Well, of course, neutral in addition is zero. So if we start off by doing zero, then every time we add k, and I'll unsuppress this so you can kind of see it happen, but we should be able to get what we're looking for. So we're going to save this as some integers, and we should see some integers over here on the left. All right, so if I go, let's see, format compact, if I go some integers of 5, I should get 15, right? Because I'm adding the numbers. So you'll see I start with 0, adding 1, and then 1 plus 2, plus 3, plus 4, plus 5, and then the answer is 15. And of course, once I know it's working, I can suppress the intermediate output in the function. So if I just do some integers, I hit the up button, that makes that happen, and I get 15 out of it. So that's kind of like a little warm-up to get started to kind of get your brain going again. So we're going to do the same thing, but we're going to do it for a product. All right. So the difference between what we had before, this used to be a sigma, a giant sigma is an S in, I guess, Greek or something, and so S is for sum. This is like a capital pi, and the pi stands for product. So really what this is it's a factorial function, but instead of being in a recursive definition, we're going to throw it back into a for loop again. All right, so let's start a new function, starting with the word function. And I think I tell you what. Oh yeah, I just tell you right there. You're going to call it y equals my factorial n. Okay, so this is my factorial. And I can go ahead and save it, and it'll automatically save as my factorial. And then what we're going to do is we're going to kind of do the same thing we did with the integers. So if you kind of want to try and do this on your own, kind of look at what we did here, pause the video and go work on this and see if you can figure it out. Okay, well, we'll assume that happened. So again, reading this, you should be reading a for loop. So for k going from 1 to n, I want to do something. So what I want to do is every time I see y or go through this, I want to multiply the previous value of y. So instead of addition, I'm just doing a multiplication. So addition becomes multiplication. Now, if you start off by going, awesome, so I'm just going to do this and I'm going to be good to go, and I'm going to try my factorial of 5. I get 0. And then hopefully you pretty quickly go, oh yeah, Because basically the idea is if you are, so we did one, we did zero over here, right? Because the neutral of summation is adding zero. Well, the neutral of multiplication is multiplying by one. So we actually want to initialize. So in case you're not sure, this is called the initialization, is you're initializing the first value of y. And so now if I come over here again, I can hit the up button so I don't have to type anymore. There I'm getting the 1, 2 times 2 is 2, times 3, times 4, and times 5. And once I know I'm getting the right answer, I can go ahead and I can, suppress the stuff, and my factorial will give me 5. So now we're going to actually get away from what I thought was kind of like a warm-up of like, oh yeah, I can't remember what we're doing. And now we're going to get into the bulk of this, which is talking about how many steps does it take the computer to actually complete an action. So what we're going to do is we're going to fix our formula or our factorial function, and we're going to have it count the number of operations. So it's going to have two outputs. You can do this in MATLAB. It's kind of fun. Y, and I know you can do it in other languages, but like in C, it's really annoying. So we're going to have Y and operation count, and we're going to call it my factorial count. So this is how we're going to set it up. So basically every time we do an operation, we're going to, well, count it. Okay. So I'm going to call this function Y. I don't want to spell operation count that many times. I'll just call it op count is going to be equal to, what did we decide to call it? My factorial count N. Beautiful. Isn't that lovely? Okay. So it's actually going to be similar. I'm just going to copy this over because thank you. Save it as my factorial count. So it's still going to be calculating the factorial the way I wanted it to before, but I want to count the number of operations that I'm doing. So now there's a couple of, okay, I know that you can get like a lot more into it because technically everything you're doing can be considered an operation. You're going one to n, you're like adding one, so there's an operation there. I know, I'm trying to go for like the overall picture of the world. This is not like a hardcore big O notation kind of lecture. We're just trying to introduce the concepts of like things take steps. Okay, so if we're trying to add, then we would say, okay, here is an operation, right? We're multiplying y times k. Sweet. So what are we going to do? So we would say that the operation count is going to be whatever it previously used to be plus 1, because we're adding one operation every time we go through this loop. But this does mean that we need to initialize operation count, because see, if I go and I try to run it, and you have to be a little careful, there's actually two outputs. So whenever you're typing this out, you have to say, give me the first output and the second output, my factorial count of 5, like that. And it's going to yell at you because you haven't defined operation count. So if you're thinking about it, how are you going to initial operation? So when you think about, all right, what would it need to be initialized at? Take a minute, think about it. Well, it's probably going to be 0 or 1. Well, in this case, it's going to be 0 because we're adding. So the neutral for addition is 0. Okay, so now we're going to try this again. And it's saying, okay, we get an answer of 120, and it took 5 operations to get there. Now, okay, this is because we're not reading the directions. So the directions say we want to use the minimum number of computations. And this is important for programming. Now, in the grand scheme of things, for this particular problem, is it a big deal? No, but that's not the point. We're trying to learn concepts. And in real examples where it would be the point, then we'd spend like 3.5 hours explaining the example to begin with. Okay. So when you look at this, is there some kind of an activity that we're doing that's unnecessary? Like, are there any operations that are totally useless to get started? Think about it, think about it, think about it. Okay, so hopefully you're saying, well, when I start with k and I take 1 times 1, that's kind of a waste of time. Absolutely. So why are we multiplying 1 times 1? There's really no reason to. So what I want to do is I want to start with 2. So that way, instead of starting 1 times 1, I'm starting at, if I throw in like a 1 for n, so I'll put this in here. If n equals 1, this won't run at all. So it'll just completely skip that for loop. So I can just say, because it'd be 2 to 1. So it'd be like, oh, I guess we're not doing anything there. So it would skip that entirely. I'll show you. If I go operation, my factorial count of 1, see, it comes back with 1 and no operations, which is what we would want. If I left this here at 1, if I let this here at one, then it would actually come back with an operation of one, even though it already knew the answer before it started. So I'm going to throw that in for two. And now, in theory, if I throw this in for five operations or five factorial, it should only come back in four steps. So that's kind of like the getting started. And now in the second video is when I'm going to go through the actual fun part of comparing the different NChooseK algorithms.